Hi there. So in this video, we are going to talk about how you can contribute to Metabase, and mainly by using GitHub. So the first thing is actually to define what is GitHub. So GitHub is in fact somehow a social network for developers in order to clearly explain how to fix a given issue. So to say that's a way that developers are, let's say, collaborating together in order to end the product, and this is in fact what is mostly used by free software. Of course, there are competitors to GitHub, because after all, GitHub has been bought by Microsoft. So actually, a lot of free software enthusiasts are moving away from GitHub to another platform. But so far, actually, that's the platform which is used by Metabase and by many other free software. So in this video, I'm just going to explain how you can contribute to Metabase through GitHub. So let's imagine that you're going to play with Metabase, and at some point you are experimenting, let's say, an issue, a bug. For example, it happened to me some days ago. I was looking actually for a way to unselect all the columns in Metabase, and I couldn't find a way to do it. So what I did is that I planned about writing an issue about it on Metabase. So here is the Metabase repository. And then when you click over here on Metabase, you have the possibility, when you click here on issues, to see all the bugs, all the features improvement which have been sent by the community. And if, for example, you are typing within the search bar over here your issue and you don't find it, you can click over here on new issue. And then you can select what kind of thing that you would like to push to the community, either a bug report, either a feature request, either a question and help, or either a security issue. And like this, it will be sent within the queue of issues in Metabase. In my case, prior to create a new issue, when I faced the colon issue that I was facing with Metabase, I found out that someone already wrote a ticket about it, which was the following one. So as a result, when it's like this, when someone already described the issue that you are facing, you can of course just do a like this in order to push it to the system and to say, hey, I wish we could add this feature as well. Or you can even add your point of view to this list of comments in order to say, okay, and in addition to that, I consider that this given feature should have, in addition to that, this and this given improvements. So that's one way to do it. So in some cases, you are just a contributor to an existing ticket. And in some other case, so for example, that's a ticket that I opened on Matomo, you are kind of the original contributor to this, let's say, feature suggest, and then that's the way it works. Okay, so please, before starting to say that the product is unfinished, is not good at all, always look through the issues tickets to see if a ticket has not been opened yet, see how the progress are made. You can even check that out within the milestone when you see, in fact, the different tickets that the community is currently working on and what are the progress that they made. And of course, you can contribute to the project by bringing your own ideas. And if you are a developer, you can even write the line of code in order to fix the different issues. In addition to that, if you would like to contribute to Metabase, you can also publish your different questions over here on the forum, or you can even help some other people by explaining them how you can fix the given issues. To say here, it's kind of interesting that here in Metabase I see that some people are talking with how to upload a CSV file, and actually I find out a way you can upload a CSV file easily in Metabase. So I can easily here sign up to the forum and answer to those given people in order to say, hey, I have an answer to this issue. And that's it for today. So do not hesitate to contribute to Metabase through GitHub or through the forum in order to help the community grow. Thanks for watching.